blessings and blessings from the beautiful nature of Topanga, California. Today's transmission is the three ways to supercharge your relationship and deepen it in ways that you didn't know were possible. Now make sure you watch to the end and make sure that you hit that red subscribe button if you're new to the family. I want to start by saying that I've been in a deep, powerful relationship with my wife, Alexi, for the last 8 years. And there are so many things that I have learned throughout this journey that I'm gonna attempt to help you understand and help you take your relationship to the next level. I wanna caveat this whole conversation by saying that every relationship is a snowflake, but there are principles that when applied can take what was good and make it great, can take what was barely getting by and glorified roommates to levels of bliss that maybe you didn't know were possible. So principle number one is appreciate. If you want to take your relationship to another level, if you want to deepen and supercharge your relationship, you get to begin to appreciate the quirks and the differences between you and your partner. Our differences can be the thing that initially attracts us to them, but then becomes also the thing that is most annoying about them later on. And I want to remind you that when we put our attention and intention on appreciation, what we begin to notice is ways in which our partner adds variety to our lives, gives us an opportunity to break through some of the wounds and things that we came with before we ever got into this relationship. Now, side note, I'm of the belief that every single one of us came with a backpack full of traumas into our relationship. And we walk in, and every time something happens, every time we get triggered by the way that he's chewing or she's asking you about whether you lock the door when you lock it every other night, whatever those things are, we begin to unload the rocks in our backpack in our partner's space and blame them for it. So I want to remind you that appreciation, when you begin to look at and love on and appreciate your partner in a way that almost makes you laugh, where you're like, wow, this person is so drastically different than me. Space from which you guys relate to each other will change, and your partner, ooh, let this land, your partner will feel it. You will move from judgment and criticism and critique of their character to appreciation. That's a big energetic jump. And once you build a bridge from all of those things to appreciation, it literally feels like somebody is nourishing your whole soul. Principle number two is connect. So many of us don't allow ourselves to purposely, intentionally spend time with our partners connecting in the way that we know fills them up. You see, it's so easy, especially in marriage, or if you've been in a long-term relationship, it's so easy to be in this routine, mundane thing where you come home, this happens, that happens, this happens, you turn on your favorite Netflix binge show. By the time you look up, it's been 3 years and nothing's really happened. Making sure that you connect, making sure that you spend time dropped in, being curious about each other. Connection isn't always about speaking. Sometimes it's just a back rub. Sometimes it's holding someone's hand. Sometimes it's you being the person who comes to the other side of the bed to snuggle with your partner. We all fall into these patterns, and I want to remind you to never, never, never stop dating each other. And by dating, I don't mean these grand, big things. Those can be a part of it, but it doesn't need to be that only. Dating meaning surprise. Dating meaning play. Dating meaning connecting in whatever way you know, maybe your partner doesn't even know that they're looking for. So for example, sometimes Alexi will be folding clothes in our bedroom, and I'll sneak up behind her and I'll grab her, and I'll sort of like WWE wrestling, I'll pick her up and slam her on the bed on top of me and then start tickling her. And she hates this and loves it. Because by the time I stop, we're both giggling, we're close to each other, our faces are close, and it's this beautiful intimate moment that is created out of nothing. It is a bid for love. I'm depositing love into our relationship account. And I want to remind you that that's super important. Now, principle number three, and this to me may be one of the most important ones. It is to protect. Protect your partner's peace. Protect your partner's traumas. Protect your partner's solitude. Protect your partner at all cost. You see, we can quickly and easily become the judge and the jury and the executor of our partners. We can notice their wounds and then poke them and blame them for not being bigger than them or not knowing how to navigate them or not knowing how to come out of them. And I'm here to remind you that when you begin to protect your partner's nervous system, when you begin to purposely look for ways to protect them, if you know that your partner, using the five love languages, really loves acts of service, and you know that you haven't been doing that, do whatever you can to protect your partner from feeling not loved by creating an act of service. If you know that there is a person in your community, in your friend group, who maybe has a toxic view of your relationship and she's speaking into or about your partner, protect your partner by extricating, by removing yourself from that relationship so that your partner doesn't have to feel the energetic dissonance of this person's idea about you, nor do they need to feel that you don't have their back. This is all a part of protecting, and there's so much more and so many other ways. I challenge you to figure out how to protect your partner's wounds. Protect, like if you know, and this is the last one, if you know your mom or dad has a big personality and they sort of steamroll your partner, protect them. Make a way to make sure that they know that you care about them and their wounds and the things they're working through. We are all works in progress, and we're all walking each other home. Back to the heart, back to the self. If this landed for you, if this resonated for you, if there's one particular one that you know you need to turn the volume up on, please leave a comment below. Click the red subscribe button if you're watching this on YouTube. If you're watching this anywhere else, just make sure you share it and tag a few friends in it, because this is the only way my messages get anywhere. Blessings and blessings from my heart to yours. I am, we are. Hashtag Love's Voice is going down in a beautiful major way. Live love, give love, be love.